Hello everybody, Rob here, Trev2323, that's T-R-E-V-2323. I just came to shoot a little video because this meathead right here has me on pins and needles again. He's been spending most of the day, honestly, he's swimming around right now. He's been spending most of the day floating at the top. Just literally floating with half his mouth out the water, half his mouth in the water. I've been having to go back to force feed him again because he's not eating on his own again. So kind of, I'm feeling like, I love the fish, I love the guy, you know, but am I just keeping him existing? Like, should I let him try to, see, he's just swimming into the end right there. Should I just leave him, try to eat on his own, and if he doesn't, you know, just so be it? Because in the wild, he'd have probably been dead already. But like I said, every time I come down here, I have to feed him again. It's been like the past 2 days. So I'm going to throw some shrimp in here, and we'll see if they eat this beast right here. You know, he's thick and thin. He's been through everything with me. But see, there he goes again. It's not partials, it's not water changes, because I bought that python hose. Every other day I've been changing this water all the way down. I mean, that gravel right there with that python, man, it gets the dirt from the undergravel filter. That's badass. Anyways, I'm going to try feeding him. We'll see what happens. All right, see what I mean? He's just floating at the top. He literally is just floating there. And I've been feeding them shrimp now, spoiling them. But I've been... See? I need to grab him. He's fine because I've been grabbing and feeding him. But he will not eat by himself. So if I get one of these right now, I could probably feed him right here. One of these in his mouth. See, now he's awake. But this is how I've been feeding him to keep him alive. That's how I've been keeping him alive. He spit it out right now. Oh yeah, yeah, he spit it out already. Well, he might be on his last leg. There goes Squishy to eat it. All right, well, I'm gonna cut some of these up and cut a smaller piece and try to feed him still. But I said I was gonna stop doing this because his butt needs to eat on his own. He's over there at the top. And I put the smaller piece in. See him swimming around? He's fine now that he got a smaller piece. But that's how it's been for a while. Well, I'd say maybe 3 or 4 days now. That's kind of how he's been. But he won't eat on his own now. See? Now I fed him and look at him. He's fine. Swimming around as happy as could be if I feed him myself. And this guy right here is a beast. Look how big he is. That's a 130 he's in. So I'm going to cut another little small piece. See his little belly? You can see the food in it. I push it in with my finger. And you can see his little belly. So I'm going to put some more food in there. Just a little bit more for him. And I just feel like I'm the only reason why he's still alive. Like maybe... he don't got the will himself to live and survive. I'm just kind of force feeding him to make it. So I don't know how much longer I should go with this. What do you think? Either way, talk to you later. Bye-bye.